Welcome. In today's video, we'll explore the basics of Azure Functions and hosting locations. Azure Functions offers event-driven, serverless computing without resource maintenance. Stateful and Stateless functions play pivotal roles. Azure App Service facilitates diverse application hosting with language support and automated deployment. Join us to unlock the potential of these Azure offerings. The goal of this video is to narrate the Microsoft Learn content, demystify these concepts, and add additional information when needed, making concepts easier to comprehend. You can follow along on the Microsoft Learn page. A triangle with MS in the center shows the page number of the Microsoft Learn unit. The learning objectives for this video are: conduct a brief introduction to the basics of Azure Functions and describe application hosting options, including Azure Web Apps, containers, and virtual machines. Azure Functions is an event-driven, serverless compute option that doesn't require maintaining virtual machines or containers. If you build an app using a virtual machine or containers, those resources must be running for your app to function. Azure Functions are like your alarm clock. When the alarm clock goes off, you wake. With Azure Functions, an event wakes the function, alleviating the need to keep resources provisioned when no event occurs. Let's take a moment and watch the video by Microsoft on serverless computing in Azure.
In this video, we'll discuss what we mean by serverless computing. Let's begin. So, as a software developer, you want to spend time doing what matters, building your application. You don't want to spend your time executing tedious, time-consuming tasks, like installing an operating system or downloading system updates. The goal of serverless computing is to help you with this by taking care of those tiresome types of server management tasks so that you can focus your effort on getting your application to your customers. So, that said, serverless computing is a bit of a misleading name because there are, in fact, servers being used. But what it really means is that the responsibility of managing servers is already handled for you. So, in other words, it's an abstraction of servers so that you can take your mind off of infrastructure concerns and focus them on developer concerns. There are three big benefits of using serverless approach. First, there's no infrastructure management. So that's the first big one. And as a business, this means that you don't have to focus on administrative tasks like installing an operating system. Instead, you simply deploy your code and it automatically runs with high availability. The second benefit is scalability. And as your application grows in popularity, you can rest assured that no matter what, your application will continue working under any workload. In fact, serverless compute can scale from nothing to tens of thousands of requests without any configuration. Finally, the third benefit we want to point out is that you only pay for what you use. You see, serverless computing is event-driven, and that means that resources are only allocated from a direct action. So you are only charged for time it takes to run your code instead of paying for the resources if they're not being used. And when all is said and done, time is money in the business world. And as such, you want to be focusing your time on what matters. Using Azure to support serverless computing through products like Azure Functions, your main job will simply be to upload your code, and you'll automatically get the benefits of infrastructure management and scalability, plus a payment model that will only charge you for what you use.
Azure Functions is ideal when you're only concerned about the code running your service and not the underlying platform or infrastructure. Use Azure Functions to perform work in response to an event, often via a REST request, which sends a message to the server, a timer, or a message from another Azure service when that work can be completed quickly, within seconds or less. Functions scale automatically based on demand, which may be a good choice when demand is variable. Azure Functions run your code when triggered, and when the function finishes, it automatically deallocates resources. This model only charges you for the CPU time used while your function runs. Functions can be either stateless or stateful. When stateless, which is the default, they behave like they're restarted whenever they respond to an event. When they're stateful, called durable functions, a context is passed through the function to track prior activity. Functions are a vital component of serverless computing. They are also a general computing platform for running any code. If the developer's apps change, you can deploy the project in an environment that isn't serverless. The flexibility allows you to manage scaling, run on virtual networks, and even isolate the functions. Now, what if you need to host your application on Azure? If you need to host your application on Azure, you might initially turn to a virtual machine or container. Both virtual machines and containers provide excellent hosting solutions. VMs give you a maximum control of your hosting environment and allow you to configure it exactly how you want. Virtual machines also may be the most familiar hosting method if you're new to the cloud. Containers can isolate and individually manage different aspects of the hosting solution and can also be a robust and compelling option. There are other hosting options that you can use with Azure, including Azure App Service, which we'll talk about in the next video. Azure App Services enables you to build and host web applications, background jobs, mobile backends, and RESTful APIs in the programming language of your choice without managing infrastructure. It offers an automatic scaling and high availability. App Services supports Windows and Linux. It enables automated deployments from GitHub, Azure DevOps, or any Git repo to support continuous deployment model. Azure App Service is a robust hosting option that you can use to host your apps in Azure. Azure App Service lets you focus on building and maintaining your app, and Azure focuses on keeping the environment up and running. Azure App Service is an HTTP-based service hosting web application, REST APIs, and mobile backends. It supports multiple languages, including .NET, .NET Core, Java, Ruby, Node.js, PHP, and Python. It also supports both Windows and Linux environments. This module talked about Azure Functions, serverless computing, benefits, stateful stateless functions, and Azure App Services' diverse hosting options. Stay tuned for the next video, where we go a little bit deeper into the app services as we learn more about components that help make up an application. And I'd like to thank you for watching.